Blues in the Basement.
And welcome to Blues in the Basement. This is Malvin Massey here with you, along with my girl.
Cookie B, baby.
Cookie B.
What?
Good to see you, darling. I love it. We get to do this show every week.
Yes, we do.
Oh, man. Yeah, so we got to get this one going.
Oh,
so, you know,
yes.
We're always listening to the blues singers.
Hello.
And the lyrics of the blues songs, mm-hmm. like Bobby Rush can sometimes mm-hmm. be a little risque. This time, we just got the music going.
Blues.
Instrumentals.
Loving it.
Thank you.
Without words. Oh my God, Malvin.
Yeah, I'm living a good time with that. Like, we're going to have a good time with
this. Yes, we are. So, yeah. Mr. Buddy Guy in slow blues.
Yeah. Did you know he could play the piano like that?
Who knew?
Yeah, you know, nobody thinks about it because we always think about the singing.
The singing. That's. I mean, yeah, and then when you finally, I mean, but think about it. We do listen to the music. So, yeah. Like, hey, the music without the words, and hey, that feeling is still there, right?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God, that was wonderful. So, that track, he was taken from Jimi Hendrix?
Yeah. Yeah. He was playing the guitar.
Oh,
yeah,
right.
I'm sorry. I said he would call him a piano player. He played, he's a guitar
Maybe.
Player.
What?
But that was cool, yeah. And he, you know, Buddy Guy, we don't think about it, he's part of Chicago Blues. We did the whole show
yes,
about Chicago
we did.
Blues
yes,
people.
We did.
And that was a classic there.
Okay, so he's a great guitarist and came through with that one, Slow Blues.
As well, good know, as it gets, that's the name of that CD from 1998.
As good as it gets. Ooh, yeah. That was a good one. That was a classic. Oh, my gosh.
So that's what we're doing. We are all so familiar with the haunting strains of blues
vocals. Ooh, say that again. That sounds so sexy.
The voices of men and women telling their stories in the most soulful way imaginable. But we can't forget that we're talking about musicians, and most blues artists are very talented. Guitars, harmonicas, pianos, and a host of other instruments. We've done that too.
Oh, yes, we have.
And we're going to feature some more.
Yes, we are. Yeah. Jeanette Owens, if you're listening, girl, I know she's your greatest fan out there.
Oh,
you
that's
know
so
that.
Sweet. Well, this next one, we're doing our hometown gentleman.
Yes, we are the King, B.B. King, and Sladen and Gladden here on Blues in the Basement.
Thank you.
welcome back. I know everybody enjoyed the King. B.B. King.
Man, knows he can play that Lucille.
Oh, my goodness. Lucille came through on that, didn't she?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my.
Plus the fact that, you know, we talked about his band that he took to New York with him and how they had a jazz thing going. And that was his band.
He loved the jazz.
Yeah, his New York band was behind him in that on that album.
That's amazing.
Isn't that cool?
So he's singing blues, playing blues. Wanted to hear that jazz to open up that set, huh?
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
But that on that track right there, Slide and Gliding, that's from that Spotlight on Lucille.
Okay. Yeah. The Spotlight on Lucille. Everybody knows Lucille.
Yeah.
Even Kenny Rogers had a Lucille, but it wasn't B.B.'s Lucille.
Oh, Kenny Rogers named his guitar B.B.'s Lucille?
Heck no. You know he had the song, You Took Picked a Long Time or something.
It took a long time to leave me Lucille. Yeah, that's right.
But we like the King's Lucille. What? Yeah.
You know, we told that story, too, how B.B. was playing a gig down there in Mississippi, and it was back in the day, and they had a 55-gallon drum in the middle of the floor heating the place up. Full of coal oil, and two guys got to fight, knock coal oil over, set the plug on fire. Everybody ran out there. B.B. thought about it, ran back in there to get his guitar. And when he found, and then he realized how dumb that was, go back to get there in the fire.
So she had to have a name, right?
So he had to find out the name of the lady they were fighting over, and her name was Lucille. So he started naming his guitar Lucille.
So the guitar was a little infamous, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Lucille.
He could play that sucker.
Yes, he could. Nobody could pick that thing like B.B. King.
Yeah. So we got another one of the three kings.
Yes, we do.
Of the guitar coming
up. Ooh, yes, we do. Next, we've got Freddie King of Stumble.
Thank you.
And we're back. I'm your girl, Cookie B, with my guy, Malvin Massey.
What do you think about the stumble?
Ooh, Professor. Like the stumble.
That. I like that.
Okay.
That's Freddie King from his CD, My Feeling for the Blues.
Oh, my goodness. So he's another great guitarist, right?
Oh, yeah.
Although he could sing, too. I see he had really good vocals. But, oh, in this, oh, yeah, he's a master guitarist, all right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. What do you call him? One of the three kings.
Oh, yes, the three kings of the blues guitar. Can we name them?
Of course, we gotta.
B.B., Albert King, and then we have Jimmy King.
Freddie King.
Oh, same thing. Sorry, Mr. King.
Freddie King, yeah.
Not Dr. King, but sorry, Mr. King.
Jimmy King. Jimmy was...
We did have Jimmy King on one of our shows. But sorry, Freddie King, the stumble. I guess I had a rumble. On the stumble.
I like that one. We're doing the instrumentals here on Blues in the Basement.
We're
not going to hear any singing this time. We're just going to hear gigging this time.
What are we going to hear, baby? I like
gigging.
That.
Gigging.
Gigging.
Yeah, gigging with the axe.
I should have been a musician. Damn it. Yeah. Darn it.
Gigging with the axe. That's what we all musicians call it.
Well, I see you got on your Kudzukian green today.
Oh, yeah.
You're feeling yourself. So we better pay some bills.
Right on.
We're going to go and listen to some Kudzukian funky politic commercials, and we'll be right back here on Blues in the Basement.
This is Tony Green, and you're listening to Blues in the Basement, powered by the Kudzukian Network.
Sports.
Brother Rashad McCants, welcome to R&R on Sports.
Thanks for having me, brother.
It's R&R on Sports.
And it's Blues in the Basement. We are back with our instrumental show.
Oh,
it's, we call it Blues Without Words.
Without Words. And Melvin giving us a double dose coming up. We're going to have a double dose.
Yeah, well, you know, some of these tracks, there's one thing about it, you know, a lot of these... As a matter of fact, a lot of blues is short.
Oh, wow.
You know, these cats do short tunes. It's like from back in the 40s with jazz and stuff.
You
get two-minute songs.
Yeah, but it gets you, right?
Oh, yeah, it gets
so
you.
I
ran up on a Frank Sinatra song that was a minute and 22 seconds long.
And that was it?
That was it.
You know, and it was a
full
good
song
one.
With the Dorsey Orchestra, but it was a full song.
Oh, wow.
You know? And a lot of blues songs are like that, too.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of blues music is... short.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, so we got
straight to the point.
We got
the blues, baby. It's the blues.
Yeah, especially, you know, when they're doing instrumentals.
Yes.
So that's what we're doing now. And you being the mistress of the titles, mistress of the brand.
Well, Professor, you came up with this. I love this double dose. Mm-hmm. We're going to have the doctor, Dr. John, in the double dose, along with Big Walter Horton.
Big Walter. You know, that's
a big
Memphis
guy
connection.
That's Memphis connection. See, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
So here we come with Honey Dripper by Dr. John.
Yeah, this is a ragtime thing.
All right. And then we got Easy by Big Walter Horton from Memphis, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I see the picture on the cover of the album with him sitting there barefooted playing his guitar with his little barefooted brother sitting on the porch with him in a sharecropper shack. Oh,
aww,
man, it's so cold-blooded.
We need that in a... That needs to be a portrait.
Yeah.
Hey, we'll be right back.
It's a double dose.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
double dose.
Oh my goodness, my toes are still stomping over here from the honey dripper, Dr. John.
You know, that's how the music got going, was that that ragtime from Scott Joplin there, and he was doing that.
That's right. You can do anything but what? Patch your foot.
Patch your foot.
What? Feel it?
Yeah. Oh man, Dr. John Rabinette, we've been using him a couple of times at Lord's piano where he is. Good Lord.
Yeah. I'm enjoying the instrumental versions of the blues. That's just awesome. I just think this is wonderful.
It's something we don't think about.
No, we don't. Yeah. And we love music, but you're always waiting to hear, oh, what are they going to say? But if you just listen to the music, it can get you there, right?
Yeah.
Oh,
that
my goodness.
That was from the Legendary Sessions.
Yes.
From 1981. And then our Memphis connection.
Come on. Give it to us. Give us the storeroom, Big Walter.
Big Walter.
Come on.
Okay, now Big Walter ain't from Memphis per se. He was born in Horn Lake, Mississippi.
Oh, which, well,
Horn Lake is still, it's right down the road. But he grew up in Memphis.
Okay.
Big Walter, but he is one of the harmonica masters. So now we got piano player and harmonica player. Yeah, that's what we just did.
Mm.
That track, Easy Boy.
He
that's
did
a,
that.
That's a classic.
Yes,
anyway.
Yes.
And yeah, he did that. That came off of his CD called Blowing from Memphis to Chicago. Harmonica Blues, Blowing from Memphis to Chicago.
Blowing from Memphis to Chicago. I like that. And that, yeah, it did have an easy feel, didn't it?
Yeah.
Mm. Then he came up easy.
Yeah, that's really cool. I like that. It's blues in the basement.
Doing
and what we're doing is blues without words.
Yes.
And we're moving right along here.
Yes, we are. Ooh. So we did Big Walter. Mm. Now we got Lil Walter coming up.
Yeah.
Off the Wall. Wait a minute.
Oh, yeah.
Not Michael Jackson. Off the Wall.
No.
Okay, I'm just making sure. You know the blues. Enjoy.
Off the wall. Didn't sound much like Michael.
No, it did not. It had its own distinctive sound. So
that was
know.
An old song too from 1953.
Beautiful. Wow.
Yeah, that's Lil Walter from his album called Checkers. Oh no, it's not Checkers. It was Off the Wall from Lil Walter. Off the Wall CD.
Off the Wall album.
Yeah.
You know, we've been amazing for a long time, haven't we?
We have.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
The talent.
And you know something else, too, as we talk about this music is the foundation of every music that everybody hears now that came out of America.
Hello.
America's own original musical art forms.
Beautiful.
Right on. Well, it's Blues in the Basement, y'all. And we still got a little to go. We're doing Blues Without Words.
Blues Without Words.
Right on.
Just like Rooms Without Walls.
Three.
He was cheating, and back then they had a little bit more decorum and discretion.
B.
These days they don't even.
Well, they played their position.
C.
And if you get you some goodies outside, whatever. The agreement is, I don't know about it. You keep it private, and it never comes to this house.
3BC. Three Black Chicks on the Kudzukian Network.
Take us back. We're going back to Memphis now.
Yeah, we're going back to Memphis. Blues in the Basement here. Malvin Mancy.
And Cookie B.
Yeah.
Yes.
And so this time I know this is the piano player I was thinking about.
This is it. Come on, Professor. Tell us about it. Come on.
You know him. You know him. It's
Memphis Slim.
Yeah. You know, he was still playing around here. He hadn't been that long passed away.
Right, right.
And he was still gigging around here and doing recordings and stuff. Well, not too long ago.
Wow.
After Beale Street got changed over, as a matter of fact, you know.
So they keep saying that he was one of the greatest piano players of his time.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
That's amazing.
Memphis Slim, he was trained. He was one of those cats that was trained how to play the piano as a piano player, not particularly as a blues player. He learned how to play the piano, to play piano.
All right.
And just like we did Dr. John, he doing the boogie woogie.
Yes.
You know, that boogie woogie thing came from the ragtime.
There you go, yes. And, I mean, think about his first cut, though. One of his first cuts. Every day I have the blues.
Oh, yes. Turned out to be a classic.
Yes, it did. Indeed, it did.
Yeah, because we got Joe Williams doing that on the jazz
show. All right.
So, yeah.
Memphis Slim.
So Memphis Slim is getting ready to kick off on Sail On Blues.
Oh.
Yeah, Sail On Blues is from his CD. It's called As Good As It Gets.
As Good As It Gets. That's the way it goes, huh?
Yeah, Blues in the Basement.
Powered by Kudzukian.
Slim, the real boogie woogie.
Baby.
Back fact, we need to do us a show about some of the lyrics next time. Yes, we do one.
Yes, since you always said some of them are a little risque.
Little risque. We
gotta, but beer drinking, that's she's just a beer drinking woman in the.
But we ease Bobby Rush in there.
We know it'll be risque. We need to get him in here too.
I know. Memphis Slim, his real name was John Lynn Chatman.
Okay.
Born in 1915.
Wow.
That's a long time.
Blues pianist, singer, and composer. Yeah. Okay. So he led a series of bands too.
And like you said, Every Day I Have the Blues was first cut in 1947.
Oh.
Yeah, it's a standard blues and jazz standard.
Yes, it is.
Man, that's cold-blooded, though. He's what'd you say about him? He was one of the...
He wasn't the pianist. Yeah. He was the greatest piano player of his time.
Yeah,
oh,
that's what somebody called him. And you know, we were talking about it, some of these rock and roll guys and jazz guys and stuff like chocolate. Mm-hmm. But a lot of these cats, that's where they came from.
That's
who they listened to. Was these cats
they inspired
we're talking
them.
About?
Wow.
To do their rock and roll.
I wish I could say cats like you. These cats, they're so damn cool. I love that.
Well, that's music talk.
You with that jazz come over to our blues with Malvin.
Well, we're going to do Junior Walker.
Ooh, I got a story to tell you about Junior Walker. All Stars.
Yeah, we always hear Shotgun, but this one is called Cleo's Mood.
All right.
It is really cool.
Who's in the basement? So what you got?
Yeah, Cleo's Mood, Junior Walker. Ooh. And that's from the album Shotgun, Junior Walker and the All-Stars.
Yeah, everyone just knows that one.
That was from 65, and it was hot music going on in 65 anyway.
Everything hot was happening in 1965.
Yeah, and look, we played in a band. I played in a band, and it was called the Neutros.
Neutros.
We used to play at all Johnny Curry's clubs downtown and this and that. And we opened our show with Shotgun.
Shotgun.
And I had learned verbatim how to hit that solo just like Junior Walker.
So I'm going to challenge you.
I had a good time with that song.
To bring that saxophone on in here.
Right, we're going to do that eventually.
Give them some.
Eventually. I've been practicing some years. But I'm gonna have to try
so
that.
So you were part of that band. So you're a famous musician.
Yeah, right.
No, seriously.
The band, in those days, it was like the Barcades had a band, the Chapangos had a band, the Ebony Web.
Hello.
It was all these bands in Memphis. Here I was playing rock and roll and blues, or soul and blues, soul, stacks and blues.
Okay.
That's what we were doing. So we're coming up on another cat that was around at the time, back in them days.
Uh-oh.
Junior Wells. Yeah. Now, he was, he was a youngster. He was right around that same time.
He was?
Yeah, he was doing this thing.
But now, chitlins, right? And that's what he says. Not chitterlings.
No.
Not chitterlings.
Not chitterlings. No,
chitlins con carn. Oh, we're getting all fancy today.
Yeah.
Malvin, again, the professor getting a little bougie on the blues today.
Yeah, well, we all love chitlins. At least I still do.
I do, too. I just can't find them.
Can't find them. And they got to be clean, right, too. Got to make sure that somebody...
I didn't want to say it on air, but you can't eat
chitlins. Okay, we're going to get with his, though. This is
Let's do this.
Chitlins Con Carne Junior Wells from the Hoodoo Man Blues CD.
Okay, Junior.
Yeah.
Mr. Junior Wells.
Yeah, Junior Wells. Yeah, that was pretty cool track there.
That was.
Chitlins Con Carne from the Hoodoo Man CD. 65.
Hoodoo Man, okay. Yeah. 1965. Very good year.
That was interesting. But now we're going to close out with Lil Sonny King.
Let's do it.
Now, where's Lil Sonny from? He's from this area too, eh?
Well, he's from Alabama, I believe.
Okay.
So Greensboro, Alabama.
We still hitting all these cats. We're hitting.
We stay in that trifecta, Mississippi, Alabama, Tennessee.
Now, Junior Wells was out of Chicago, but he came from down this way.
Hello.
So we're going to listen to Junior Wells. The Creeper returns from the new king of the blues harmonica. It has been Blues Without Words on Blues in the Basement.
Yes, kisses.
Kisses, y'all. Thank you.
Thank you, dear.
I appreciate doing the show with you. Blues in the Basement on the Kudzukian Network. Keep it tuned. We'll be back next week.
Blues in the Basement. Directed, produced, and distributed by Kudzukian. Thank you.
Thank you.